You see, policing is a collaborative effort. And like any business, our capital is information. So if you get that right, that this work I'm doing, the capital from which I'll get my profit, which is either arrest or prevention, is information. Therefore, within the first week before I assume duty, I set up to meet stakeholders. So I met the Macho Men Association, I met the various task forces of the political parties, I met people who in course have shady characters, and put down my mission to them. That, in fact, I met some at the Golden Tulip, which a lot of people know, and in fact some of them have since then been arrested and jailed because
I met, yes.
Because I told them that I'm here. And that time, I think there was seemingly increase in crime, impunity, arbitrariness, and people seem to do whatever they like. And I told them, now I'm here. I'm also a Kumasi boy. What we all need to do is to keep the peace. But anybody who will go out of line. And secondly, you either give me information or you are against me. And since the information started forthcoming, everybody started giving, albeit some very bad information based on vendetta and revenge and all those things. So eventually, when people realize that we are working and we are not going to divulge information about informants to people, everybody started giving information. And it's still forthcoming, and we are still working on the information that we get.
Now, you adopted a regional command that had some problems. Not everything was going well here in the Ashanti region when you took over. How did you instill discipline so fast in the regional police force?
I cannot say that everything is going on well even now, because Kumasi is a very difficult place to manage, and I think I doff my hat for all my predecessors. They've all done very, very, very well, because this is more or less the center of the country. It's quite cosmopolitan. It's also traditional, and you know, power authority relations also come into play, and also is the hub of the opposition now, and it's a very hot political bed. So all these factors combined makes controlling crime very problematic. So what I realized, if the first thing I decided to do is to clean up the police station itself, to give that symbolic gesture for people to know that the police station itself has changed. So the first thing is that I gave 48 hours for all rickety cars to be removed from the police station, and it was done. Then people started to realize that something is happening. Even if you're an armed robber, you pass around now, you see that no, something really is happening. Then, when people realize that what we have done, people on their own volition started coming to contribute to refurbish the police station. And now, you can, as you are here, I think you go around and see it's comparable to any police station in the world. Then, I realized that to instill discipline in the society, you have to discipline the policemen first. So, measures were, we went back to the core values, the rituals, the beliefs. If you want to, you have to salute, you have to salute. If you have to go to work, you have to go. Then we also brought in the punishment systems and the grievance handling system, and also the reward systems. So, and also I realized that not every policeman can work in the city center. Some are made for the outskirts, some are made for the villages. So I sat down, looked at it, and I realized that there was the need for manpower redeployment. And I must thank the Inspector General of Police for also giving us a chance to also do what we are doing. Because I always say that, like Mandela said, if the leader is able to exhibit his own talents, then he unconsciously gives chance to the subordinates to also exhibit their talents. So you realize that what is happening in headquarters is just the prototype of what is happening here. So we decided to instill discipline. So after the people realized that the policemen are now clean, I mean, in terms of uniform wearing, they are smart in their appearance, and now they more or less realize that when you meet them at the snap check, they are a little bit aggressive than before, albeit in a very civil. Then, after instilling that discipline, they realize that when you put somebody at a snap check to be there from 6 to 6, the person will be there. Well, he dare not move because the punishment systems will apply. And secondly, you cannot also apply discipline without being fair. So I realized that even in the management of the police service and also management of crime, fairness is key. But when people realize that somebody can be punished and others cannot be punished, then it jeopardizes the whole system. So I made my mind that whoever is arrested, no matter your status, no matter your position in the society, you go to court. And when that started, then everybody became a little more or less cautious. And we started that if that is the case, then it can help us to break the culture of impunity, the culture of arbitrariness in the system. Because more or less, this is a quite a traditional and conventional society. So all of a sudden, you realize that nobody is coming to mitigate in crime for anybody. There's no interference. When you commit crime, you go to court. And for me, everybody knows that the commander will not listen, both political-wise and cultural-wise. And thank God, I have a very good regional minister too, in the person of Mr. Sapon, who is also security-minded and will hardly tolerate any interference. And not the least, our king, the Otumfuo himself, also gave me the permission, asked me not to tolerate anybody who used his name to my office, because I have access to him. And that has really broken every chain of interference in the system. And when majority of the people realize that everybody is equal before the law, then they will comport and comply.